Hi guys, in this video I want to show you how the organic uplift works based on an example. Because maybe you have seen the case study that I published on AppRadar with the help of AppRadar, where we increase the organic uplift for Pentaflix by a significant amount and reached an organic uplift of up to 263%, got 30 and plus keyword rankings in the top 10s, and also increased the organic installs dramatically. So great results, but I also got the feedback that it's quite abstract and that people don't necessarily really know what the organic uplift means, even that this graph gives a better idea about it. I just want to show it to you based on an example. So as you can see here, this is an example where we can see how when you're using App Store optimization versus you are not using App Store optimization, a campaign can get from non-profitable to profitable. So what you care about, of course, you're tracking all your campaigns, and you might also track your App Store optimization funnel and maybe even your organic uplift. But what I want to show to you is how it relates and how just by a slight change of organic installs your campaign get from non-profitable to profitable. The most crucial things about this table are the campaign budget is the same in both cases, the CPI is the same, but what isn't the same are the ones that are highlighted, the KPIs that are highlighted. So we have the organic uplift increased, the organic downloads therefore increased, users from search, total buyers, and then therefore the customer lifetime value and the customer acquisition cost. Of course, the customer lifetime value stays the same. This is based on the example of Readly. They have a business model where you pay 99 cents the first month, and then afterwards you pay $9.99. And the idea behind it is that a user sticks for 6 months and 5 months where they pay the full price, and otherwise the first price is discounted. So what happens when you run App Store optimization versus when you don't have App Store optimization with your campaign? What happens is you change your effective cost per install. That means that the amount of users that you get from organic get into the price that you pay for a user. So when you have your CPI, you run Facebook ads, and then for $150, you get one user from Facebook, for example. But when we consider the eCPI, the effective cost per install, we also take into consideration the organic downloads. And this is why, as you can see, this difference occurs, and also why the organic uplift is so important. I want to give you a brief example. The most crucial thing to understand is users from search is in scenario A, 100. In scenario B is 1,600. Why? Because we are doing our keyword optimization, we are doing our conversion rate optimization, we do our analysis, we analyze our competitors. We basically know and control where our app is living, and we use result-driven App Store optimization. So we have the right KPIs and we have the right process in place. And this is why having the right kind of ASO tool is so important. We used AppRadar because it's very straightforward and helps us to publish and push our changes right from the tool, and therefore we have a quick iteration cycle without all the maintenance that is needed if we don't use an ASO tool like that. So in scenario A, we have 100 organic downloads, and this is basically where the campaign is being made, or it breaks, because as you can see here, the total amount of buyers is changing. If we have 1,500 users more, we are also having more users that are likely to buy. Meaning, because we also have to consider that organic users are much more likely to convert. They have already showed the intention that they want something, want to buy something. And therefore, I have seen, I can't tell you concrete numbers, but I have seen that the conversion rate from organic to someone buying something in an app can be almost double and more considered to what is happening in paid. So organic users are very engaged because they already searched for something. And if they found your app, then they are likely to stick and likely to buy. So we have more total buyers with our campaign where we're running App Store optimization. And this is at the end why our customer acquisition cost is so much lower, because we get more users, as you can see here, we get more buyers, more users, resulting in more buyers, and therefore our campaign budget is getting lower. And therefore we pay less for a customer. And this is why at the end, your total revenue per campaign is so much lower, is so much higher when you run App Store optimization. And maybe when you're now thinking about, okay, we are doing a lot of stuff, like we are running Facebook ads, but since yet we haven't figured out how to get results like that, then I want to propose you one thing. So what I give you the chance for now exclusively is you can find a link down below to schedule a call, and let's just have a talk about this and let's see how we can use App Store optimization to feed in with your performance marketing strategy. So just click down below, schedule a call, and I'm looking forward to speak to you.